Everybody finds somebody someplace. There's no telling where love may appear. Something in my heart keeps saying, my someplace is here.
In 1964, the song you just heard, the single off of this record, knocked the Beatles out of the top spot on the pop charts. Give Dino a little respect. Oh, hey, vinyl community, and welcome YouTubers from everywhere. Gonna show you and tell you a little bit about a few Dean Martin records. And you're probably wondering, audiophile, what the hell? Well, just stay tuned. Dean Martin, the king of cool. Of course, earlier on, he was part of the Lewis and Martin, Jerry Lewis and Dean Martin comedy act. In 1953 and 1955, he had an LP out, but in 1956, he broke up with Jerry Lewis and went solo. In 1957, this record came out, Pretty Baby. Yeah, they're both pretty babies, aren't they? This is a hard record to find a nice, clean copy of. I'll give you a little taste of it on here.
Everybody loves a baby, that's why I'm in love with you. Pretty baby, pretty baby. And I'd like to be your sister, brother, dad, and mother too. Pretty baby, pretty baby. Won't you come and let me rock you in my cradle of love, and we'll cuddle all the time. Oh, I want a loving baby, and it might as well be you. Pretty baby of mine.
This on the early Green Capital, almost turquoise label. My friend Jacob over at the Dallas Open Knocker channel, he commented several times on this record. I think his favorite Dean Martin, This Time I'm Swinging, 1960, with the Nelson Riddle Orchestra. We know what Nelson Riddle did a little later for Linda Ronstadt, don't we? We'll give you a little taste of that. Here it has a $9.95 price tag on it. It's one of his better records. It's very clean. I probably got it for about $8. I'm going to show you some more Dean Martin records, and most of them came out of the dollar bin.
You're nobody till somebody loves you. You're nobody till somebody cares. You may be king, you may possess the world and its gold, but gold won't bring you happiness when you're growing old. The world still.
Okay, gonna show you a little group of Martin records here. Dean Martin, in 1959, he did two country records. Dean Tex Martin, arranged and conducted by Marty Paich. Really good record. Dean Tex Martin, Country Style. These were popular, well-selling records, and I'm really happy to have these. A few years back, I did a video, How Country Music Got Free. I guess that wasn't a good title because almost nobody watched it. But I talked about how popular singers like Dean Martin, Ray Charles, and some others in the early 60s did country music albums that crossed over and give those city folks a little taste of country music, and they liked it. So don't laugh at this, folks. This is good music. Here I got one for probably, again, about $7, 1978, Sealed, Once in a While. Here's one marked $2. I probably paid $1. Welcome to My World, Still in the Shrink. Another one of my favorites, Remember Me, I'm the One Who Loves You. He did a lot of these on the reprise with his buddy Frank. Got a second copy of that one in the shrink. You know, when you get them for $1, it's hard to pass up. Here's one that Unimart was $3.67 when it came out. The Door Is Still Open to My Heart, Still in the Shrink, $1. Dean Martin, in the what would be my modern era, has always been my favorite male singer. Dean Martin, A Million One Come Running Back Shades, Still in the Shrink, $3.67 when it was new, again out of the dollar bin. Happiness is Dean Martin. Might have had to pay $4 for this one, but again, Still in the Shrink, clean copies. Somewhere there's a someone, Dean Martin. These are all good records. And the last one I have here, Gentle on My Mind. Probably had to pay $6 for this one, but again, these are super clean copies. And so that's my little group here. Now, what about this audiophile business?
If you were the only girl in the world, and I were the only boy, nothing else would matter in the world today. We would go on loving.
Started out in the open there showing you this record. I just picked this up the other day. I showed you this the other day. Over at the Antique Mall, really clean VG++ copy for $3. This record sounds great. What's the deal here? On this record is Barney Kessel, one of the all-time great guitar players, Ken Lane on piano, who was his pianist for many years, including the pianist on his long-running TV show, Red Mitchell on bass, and Irv Kotler on drums. Now, Dino, at heart, was a lounge singer, and this is one of the few records he made that has that kind of atmosphere. Many of his records, when he got so popular, had the strings layered over the top of them and big orchestras, and that took away from the intimacy of this kind of record. On the Reprise label, where do we get audiophile? In 2014, this record was reissued by Analog Productions. That was about the time I got back into vinyl. This is probably the first audiophile record I ever bought. Certainly one of the first ones. This record is fantastic. It was so good, I also purchased the high-res download file so I could listen to it a little more conveniently. This was Lacquer Cut by Ryan K. Smith, pressed at Quality Record Pressing, 2LP, 45 RPM. This record, Dean, is standing right there in your living room. It's just fantastic. Of course, it was never originally. The gatefold jacket. Great Stoughton jacket, double LP, 45 RPM. one of the favorite records in my collection. I have a lot of audiophile records, and I certainly do not have any that sound any better than this record. So, yeah, Dean Martin was a classy guy. He was a hunk, and he was an audiophile.
I don't know why I love you like I do. I don't know why I just do. I don't know why you thrill me like you do. I don't know why you just do. You never seem to want my romancing. The only time you hold me is when we're dancing. I don't know why I love you like I do.
So I say keep 'em spinning and see you all over at the lounge.
I'm sending you a big bouquet.